Let's discuss now the remaining financial statements, the statement of comprehensive income, as well as the statement of cash flows. Basically, there are four types of items that we must include in this concept of comprehensive income. First, net unrealized holding gains and losses. Also, gains and losses from our post-retirement benefit plan, such as our pensions. Thirdly, our deferred gains and losses from derivatives or swaps. And lastly, any foreign currency gains or losses. So let's further discuss the statement of comprehensive income, or SOCI. As discussed previously, the statement summarizes the changes in shareholders' equity that were not part of our net income on the income statement. These gains and losses are reported as other comprehensive income, or OCI. So again, why do we separate this? What's the point of all this? Well, the point is by separating these types of items, we can help our users of the financial statements know about changes in equity that do not belong on the income statement. As discussed before, comprehensive income can be reported one of two ways. In two separate but continuous statements, such as Apple Inc. does it that way, or in a single combined statement of comprehensive income. It should also be noted that cumulative impact of all of our OCI items are reported as a separate component of shareholders' equity in the balance sheet, which is called AOCI, or Accumulated Other Comprehensive Income. We saw this category when we showed the Apple Statement of Shareholders' Equity in an earlier session. As previously discussed, the Statement of Cash Flows, or SCF, is comprised of three sections. First of all, we have the operating section, which reflects the change in cash resulting from transactions involved in the determination of net income, such as inventory purchases. This section can be reported by the direct or, more commonly, the indirect method. In fact, 98% of all companies use the indirect method. Next, we have the investing section, which is a change in cash resulting from purchase or sale of our long-lived assets, such as the purchase or sale of property, plant, and equipment, as well as investments. And thirdly, we have the financing section, which relates to our external financing of the company, those transactions that occur with our creditors or investors, such as stock issuance, cash dividends, loans, and related payments.